Man, if you like stats, there are some stats. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the WGLNA Season 2 Gold League. I'm your host, Christian Toma. To my left, David Williams. Make sure to check us out on Facebook and YouTube /WGLNA. If you're not watching this on battleviewer.com, go over there right now and check it out. And finally, follow us on Twitter at WGLNA so you guys can stay up to date on what's happening in the community around you. One of the things that's happening is Quinn is going to be back on Thursday for the playoffs. That's right, in just 2 days. So you have that time to ask us questions using hashtag mailbag at WGLNA, and we will be answering them here live on the show. And another thing you guys can do is answer for us the question of the day,
which is, who did you vote for the Pro Bowl?
The Pro Bowl voting that I have done is for Meadowhawk, Ox Thief, Jay Smooth, and Brett. Those are my four choices and four picks. David, what are yours?
Just Meadowhawk.
Just Meadowhawk, indeed. Let us know, guys, right now in chat who you are picking for the Pro Bowl to play as we're getting ready to go into our next battle. It's Noble versus Rival. So a fun, exciting battle indeed. On the side of Noble, we have Comps. On the side of Rival, we have Jay Smooth. Gentlemen, welcome to the face-off. Comps, going to go ahead and start with you. Again, the theme of the night, this is the final battles, this is the final matches of you guys' teams for the regular season. So looking back as a team captain, what has been Noble's biggest highlight for the season?
Biggest highlight was probably our initial streak of victories. Our low light was that loss versus Simp, but we've come back from that.
Yeah. Let's not talk about the low light. We can talk about the highlight. But that, yeah, absolutely, a win streak is definitely a high point for sure.
So what you're saying is the highlight was when Cliffs was going well, and then the low light was when it went horribly wrong.
Indeed.
Yeah, that tends to be the case on Cliff.
That'll do it.
All right, Comps. Who are some of the unsung heroes on Noble?
Oh, myself. I mean, no. I'm the one.
This bit's already been done. This bit's already been done. You're late to the train.
Yeah. Yeah, Ali beat you to it.
Well then, I'd say Germ. I mean, he was holding up the reins early on with the calls and stuff, so I'd say he's probably the unsung hero of the team.
Oh yeah, Germ. Germ, I remember him from last season.
Cool story.
All right, Jay Smooth, over to you, sir. Same thing for Rival, Simple Tankers. Looking back at the season, what has been the biggest highlight for you guys as a team?
I think the biggest highlight is just the way we've been able to stay together, keep going forward. Got into a big slump, worked our way back, picked up Commander Jay, gives us a little morale boost. Getting off to the right start on even though it was a loss, it was still a point against High Voltage early. So I'd say getting off to a good start and coming back.
All right. Yeah, congratulations. It's been super fun to watch you guys play this entire season.
Who are some of the unsung heroes on Rival Simple Tanker, Smooth?
Gosh, this team's been together for so long. I mean, Ruthven doesn't get a play in, but he's at every practice, and he's always making us better. Flack picking up a lot of the small stuff when it comes to admitting. Vo did a lot. You know, he saw the videos. He does a lot of content for us, even though he stepped down. He's still a part. Unknown making calls. I mean, if you lose anybody on this team, we're in trouble.
Love it. That shows that team cohesion so well. Jason, thank you so much for that. Gentlemen, before we get into the third match of the night, Comps, is there anything you'd like to say to Jay Smooth before we get started?
Good luck and have fun.
All right, Jay Smooth, your response?
I just want to thank all the fans for last regular season game, for watching everything, Twitter, in-game chat. You guys are awesome. I have something for you, Comps, though. You've won a trophy. This is trophy time, Pro Bowl, everything. Here's your trophy, boy, right here. WGLNA, Water Boy, Laundry Guy of the Year, man. If you got a load that needs to be done, you give it to Comps. He'll take it. He'll get it done.
All right.
Here's your trophy, Team Manager of the Year.
Well, thank you so much for that. Maybe I should have asked Comp's response to that. I want like a counter response, but we don't have time. Gentlemen, best of luck to both of you, and we'll see you shortly.
See you in the danger zone.
So now, yeah.
Well, now. So, let's go ahead and take a minute to go over the Fantasy WGL pre-match page. What? As Rival said, first off. Or it's Jay Smooth said. He's got to be the number one hero on the team. I mean, had the teams kept together for so long? Well, let's get this over with. Noble, Cliff, played the most, but not for a while now. T22 being their most used tank, along with Rival, same thing. And Rival prefers to play Steps a lot. Canadian Impact leading the points for Noble at the moment, and Executus leading for Rival Simple Tankers. So, what I was going to say is, you know, they stayed together for a very long time, and he talked about why everybody is completely indispensable on the team. Sounds to me like that's why the team stayed together for so long, yeah. Is because you got a leader like Smooth there.
Absolutely.
Keeping everything together. Now, on top of that, I said something before we went to break about AM60s being an eighth. I was getting ahead of myself.
Okay.
I was thinking eighth until we find out who wins between Simp and, or between Noble
and Rival.
Gotcha. This is an incredibly important match for both teams. Actually, my miscalculation for Ding is now having ripple effects all the way down everything. Probably could not have done a worse job in that instance. So, Ding, now that they're out, it opens up a possibility for Simple Tankers to be out as well, because if they had beaten AM60s, it would have been a very different landscape. A whole different mess of stuff that I now have to put out of my mind.
Okay.
So right now, Simple Tankers are in eighth with 16 points. And they absolutely need to beat Noble to climb out of that position. And Noble has to win to keep the first.
Wow. A huge game for both of these teams right now, ladies and gentlemen. So let's get right into it. Starting out on Mines, Noble on offense, Rival on defense. Let's take a look at what we've got for tanks.
So now that last game has passed, all of my initial numbers are now accurate.
That's crazy. What a game.
Feels bad, man. Noble starting off this match with two 260s, a Batchat, two T22s, a TVP, and an RE51, Simple Tankers with an E100, an IS7, an E5, T22, and two TVPs, and an M40 and 43 on defense. See if they can make it work nearly as well as Veloxa did, as Noble looks for some early shots here. Akula taking a pretty standard spot. You know, we don't talk about positions often enough, something that Tigers pointed out to me. Something I just kind of gloss over a lot of the time, you know? It's not, we don't always have the time, so when I do see it, I don't always get to talk
doesn't
about
register,
it.
Sure.
And then other times, I just take for granted the things that I know about positional stuff.
Sure.
This one right here, where Akula is absolutely huge for hill play. It's one of the most protected areas. You've got a nice place you can drop back here for safety. You can also swing and fire to the west if you need to. You can slide down this path if things get rough. And you have beautiful shots in the hill for both track shots and everything. Timing-wise, you're going to get there very early. It's a great position. Great position overall.
All right, there you go, guys. So if you guys are playing on Mines, that's a place that you should definitely be looking out for if there's going to be a hill fight, which there usually is on Mines on public matches. I don't think I've ever been in a public match where there isn't a fight on hills.
You cram 15 tanks onto this map, things change.
Ooh, Militant.
Militant 497 out of Zakumi, and a track that opened up one opportunity for Executus to drop a bomb on him that very well could have been a very game-changing shot, but that opportunity is missed as Militant driving around the top of the hill here with relative impunity, and Noble take a little bit of time to rotate around and get a little bit more intel before they make their big decision.
Akula.
Decide where to go. Now Akula is spotted. This is a dangerous game that Noble is playing. I mean, this is inside the shot vector.
There it is!
But Executus misses, and Akula remains intact.
There you go. Two shots actually missing there onto Akula in that T22. Just kind of rocking back and forth. Now, is it possible, like, if you're Akula right now, is it possible that you just missed the artillery almost shot you? Did you? It could have just been any other shot?
No.
Okay,
I guarantee
you
he was very clenched waiting until he heard that splash. Then when he heard the splash, he's like, ah. Oh,
gotcha.
Not getting balanced for now.
So, okay, as an artillery player, like you said, when Militant was tracked there right on top of the hill to make the spot, he was spotted, and we didn't have the shot come out of Executus and the artillery. If you're an artillery and you have your reticle, you're looking somewhere else at the moment, and that happens, how quickly can you turn, re-aim?
It depends on the artillery. With the M40, M43, not very quickly.
Okay.
Even though its traverse is pretty decent, it doesn't matter. I mean, it just doesn't aim very quickly at all. It's already a very risky shot anytime you fire at M40, M43. He must have been shopping for that original position that we were talking about where Akula was to not have a shot on the hill immediately, but that's a very short run, and I would have let it go on an immobile bad shot.
Gotcha.
Just to guarantee, you say that shot lands right as he's
like
fixing his track.
Huge.
Maybe you track him again, and it gets shot by Zakumi again. Either way, something's going to come out well. So unless there was some other call there going on, a big opportunity missed by Executus, and Noble now has discovered that there are tanks in the east. They're looking like they want to rotate back west to try and capitalize on that terrain. They're going to bring this home one little piece at a time. This is pretty standard way to play mines. You can only have tanks in so many positions. And while this kind of strategy is very risky on other maps, just get intel, rotate, because the other team will rotate a lot. Once you have that hill position where Militant is and some of these other positions, you don't have to worry about it as much.
Gotcha.
Not at all, in
Makes
fact.
Sense.
And they can't really run around without getting punished. So you want them to shift around. So you can easily find this intel, rotate, intel, rotate, intel, rotate, all game long as your time management is good.
All right.
And time management with attack defense is a much, much less difficult thing to do than it was in Days of Old.
All right. Well, now 3 minutes and 48 seconds on the clock. More than half of the battle has gone. Noble is on offense, so they are the ones who are going to have to do something. They're sending a couple of the members over here on the lighthouse to start pushing up that 1-2 line. Let's see where they can kind of take that. Possibly maybe catching out Commander J. They are spotted now. Dodo spotting him out. Dodo taking a shot there. Commander J taking some as well. Over 300 damage going into both of those T-22s. A lot more damage now going into Noble. Dodo taking another shot for 433. Akula taking a little bit of damage there. Friction, I think, might have got shot there. Publisper, though, now taking some damage against Zakumi. We have a lot of shots, a lot of little fights going on all over the map.
Jeremy used that opportunity to slip on top of the hill with his 260. A nice move by him to help get more leverage into this fight. And a shot to Zakumi while he did it. Militant taking two shots for that intel. And J-Smooth driving his E-100 underneath the hill in kind of a dangerous territory, although it's not easy to penetrate that thing with all these mediums in the southwest.
All right, we'll see. Again, 2 minutes and 45 seconds on the clock, so Noble has to start doing something, and they are down quite a bit on HP here. Simple Tankers haven't taken much shots at all. Militant and J-Smooth just kind of proxy spotting each other here. Executus is on a pretty long reload, as you guys can see there. Marsh, though, being focused by Pride. 620 points of damage there in that RU251. And now J-Smooth on the side of Simple Tankers taking some shots, as well as Akumi. Take a little bit of damage, and it's starting to happen, ladies and gentlemen. Noble starting to find those shots under the tanks they need. J-Smooth getting shot from Marsh and Canadian Impact, both in the front and from the back there. Another shot from the RU251 for 214. 753, 984, one more shot. He'll be going down. The shot from Executus actually missing on a Militant, but Pride being sent in against Marsh. So Marsh takes down J-Smooth, but he goes down to Stein Pride himself. Germ takes down Zakumi in the IS-7. So it is now six tanks on Noble against the five for Simple Tankers, and this was the trigger that Noble was looking for. They're now collapsing down onto Commander J. Canadian Impact and Germ coming down off of the hill, taking those shots right into that T-22. Dodo getting extremely low, though. Commander J gonna finish him off, and now that is a 5-on-5. HP, though, is now in favor of Noble, and Simple Tankers slash Rival are starting to go down themselves as Pride takes a lot of damage. His driver's going down 95 points of HP in that 50-51. Milton finishes off there in the back chat. Akula takes down Commander J with just three takes remaining and a minute and 17 seconds left. It looks like Noble is going to find their first victory here onto Mines unless Flak and Publisher can do something amazing, because Executus is just on a long, long reload here. Friction and Publisher going head-to-head here. Friction is reloaded. Two shots right into Publisher. It's going to finish off that 50-51, leaving just Flak and Executus on the side of Rival. 500 points of damage there going into E5 here, and looks like it's all over. 50 seconds is not enough time for Flak and Executus to run away. There's nowhere Executus can go. And Noble knows exactly where he is at. 40 seconds on the clock is plenty of time to take this artillery. The question is, who's going to take it in the face? It looks like it's going to be... Oh, Friction goes down! Amazing shot coming out from Executus. Going, hey, I'm not going down without taking down a tank of my own. Noble picking up their first victory there against Rival in our third match of the night. And that's got to be a good feeling for artillery right there.
I mean, he was borderline...
Who's coming
full
around
health
who's
if he wasn't already
corner.
Full health?
You're dead. Well done there. But
I must remind everybody, this is a match that decides who has the highest points per battle in the league.
Oh.
Because either J-Smooth or Friction are currently the top two. They could both be dragged down by this.
You're
they could
right.
both be boosted, or they could overtake one another.
Everyone's going for as much damage as possible.
They're pretty much cheating by showing up late and only having to play a couple games. But let's go into the stats.
Don't think about
let's go to the stats and see who's winning.
Don't think about that, guys.
Flack 2500 in his E5, Executus 2000 in the M40, M43. But I think we can take a big chunk of that off as friction. Zakumi 1800, 1300 out of Commander J, and so on and so forth. Over here for Noble. Canadian Impact in his 260, 3191 Germ with 2700. Friction 2300 in his TVP. 2000 for Akula, and everybody else dropping off after that.
So one thing before we kind of. I just want to talk about, in my mind, the comeback that Noble just did, because looking at the entire battle, I was like, wow, they're losing a lot of HP, and they're getting to positions, but obviously, that was all according to plan. They got to where they needed to go. And
this is mine. At no point was Noble out of control
really?
There.
All right, took it to him. So a well-executed plan from Noble. But looking at the M50, M43, the artillery that Executives was in, the splash damage on that thing, I mean, Akula went to start putting cap pressure, it looked like, over on the west. He hit a house. And then he took like 200 points of damage there, and I was like, that he was like behind a wall, and he even took some damage. So splash damage coming out very well, and an amazing final kill there, but just not enough. So just Noble slow control again, getting down to 40 seconds. That's why I was like, man, like their time's running low, but they had it, no sweat.
Yep,
no sweat. Well done, Noble. Congratulations, pick up
the
first.
A little bit slower the timetable than they probably expected, but the rotations and the control that they had were
calculated.
All planned.
Well done from them. Now up 1-0 against Rival. We are switching sides. Let's get back into it and take a look at now what we've got for tanks.
Noble now on defense with 2 260s, a batch out of T22, a TVP, an E15, and a T54. Simple tankers with an IS-7, 2 batch shots, 2 T22s, a T54, and a Skoda T50.
All right, here, let's see. Bringing the Skoda. Man, I don't know why. I just love that tank. I gotta try it. I gotta try the Skoda out here. One of these days. 7 minutes and 45 seconds on the clock. Don't really need to tell you the time. It's only been about 15 seconds gone by, and we have a nice hill rush coming out from Rival. Executus leading the charge there. Pub Whisper and both of them getting spotted up. One of the shots there from Dodo going right into the side of the hill. The shot from Akula, they're connecting, and now Pride and Commander J having to be careful, starting to back off. Not as confident to continue to push to join the rest of their team on top. Pub Whisper is now fully loaded in that bat chat. And it looks like hill control going over to Rival.
I like this defense from Noble. 2 tier 9s. That gives them a lot of map presence. The big vulnerabilities of mines being that rotational play that we talked about. This gives you essentially another real tank to boost all of that. So, interesting. Interesting. We'll see how well it plays out, because the 2 tier 9s could be a weakness. I mean, oftentimes we see a tier 8 do still just quite a bit
of damage.
On mines. So it could affect things. But with an E50 and a T54, I think that that lineup is very solid for a defensive play.
All right. We'll see if that does work out for Noble here. His Rival are the ones who are on offense. They're the ones who have to start making the move. Coffee Thief is over in the lighthouse there in the F2 position. You guys can see in the mini-map. Sitting in that T54, just looking for any sort of spots they can find. Akula.
So, positionally, what I see is essentially Noble has disregarded most of the 8-9. They've got the T54 there to drive away while the E50 supports, and they'll probably do a middle shove in the event that anything comes barreling down the 8-9, which is their only real weakness. A lot of their tanks are postured and fast enough to get up there very quickly, and that will turn the battle around very, very fast. So, again, got to lather a little bit more praise here on what I'm seeing from Noble as a very dynamic, capable of being dynamic defensive strategy. Now, I'd like to see some more different positions from those tanks in previous or later battles.
Okay.
Maybe have different positions with the same tanks, and then it starts getting into a very, very, very well thought out defensive strategy.
All right, well done, Noble. Really kind of having all those different types of,
or,
if this happens.
Or perhaps those positions are perfect and it's just responses that will change. Hard to say. Either way, all I would like to see is Simple Tankers attempt to break this in different ways and see what Noble does in each way. Because I have a feeling it'd be pretty great.
How hard is it, David, again, as playing this game as a pro player, to create a strategy that has an answer for more things than it has a weakness for? Or is that even possible?
Difficult. It's far easier to bait out a weakness and or two and then get responses for those as it is to create a stopgap for all your weaknesses, because your responses to those common weaknesses will be weaknesses on their own.
Okay. Gotcha.
Say if Simple Tankers baited out a middle push and then set a trap for it, that kind of thing. So you're never done dealing with the meta here, but we're going to find out relatively soon. Yeah. Simple Tanker's probably going to wrap around the bottom side of the hill and try and pick up a Dodo, not go all the way into the southeast.
Here's the A9 push from Rival Commander Jay leading that one, taking some shots, but not taking a lot of damage. Now, finally, 777 going there in that T22. Executus making it across. He got tracked there just right at the end. And now a lot of shots going on a Canadian Impact. The focus fire for Rival paying off there as the Object 260 is now gone. A tier 10 dropping, and Dodo taking 14, 1862 in his 260. And that's another tank gone down. Commander J picking that one up. Two tanks falling for Noble. Not a single one for Rival, and they still have a lot of HP left on their side. Commander J now starting to take some damage. 574 in that T22, dodging some shots. They're dodging all the shots finally at the end there for Friction. Martian is D50 starting to chime in, but Simple Tankers has such a lead, over 2,000 points of HP. They're two tanks up, and now that push from Noble that we kind of talked about as possibly being their saving grace is now out of the picture as the rest of Rival is now down. Commander J and Executus pushing against Germ in that T54. Executus should be able to pick him up there. There it is in that bat chat. And now they're going to continue this sort of flank going around. Friction, full health. Well, now he's not. 330, they're going to him. He's going to let his entire clip go right into Flak there. 264 finishing off that one. But that is, looks like he's going to be all he's going to do. 1,074 going at him. A couple more shots, and Friction will be going down. Oh, it looks like a couple of misses coming up from Simple Tankers. He's doing a good job using that rock, but he cannot protect from everyone as Flak finds it in that I-7, leaving just Akula, Middleton, and Marsh to be able to defend for them. And it looks like Rival is going to be coming back here to tie it up. 1-1 in our third match of the night. Publix, we're going in for a ram at the end there. On to Middleton in that bat chat. Now it's just Marsh and that E50. They know where he's at. They got plenty of time to go take him down. Well done for Rival. Sort of picking apart the defense that Noble have from there onto Mines. One shot from Pride just missing. Executus will have his up. Who will it be? It will be Executus in that bat chat. Rival tying it up 1-1 there against Noble. So again, we talked about the 8-9 weakness that Noble had. And if that were to happen, the Noble would hopefully just push up the hill and find either the overmatch that they had there. That just didn't happen there.
No, actually, Simple Tankers took a pretty classic response to what happens when you start building that way.
Okay.
Something I was glossing over at the time as well. Those two tanks directly underneath the hill are then able to be focus fired by seven people. Traditionally, I don't know much about the 260, and that's where things get weird. Traditionally, you're able to hold that position a lot longer than what just happened. So perhaps it's a tier 10 difference.
Okay, a lot more
probably
damage.
Not as much. But there was also a failure to focus fire and really an improper response to what we saw right there. Most of Noble was afraid of being the people getting focused.
Gotcha.
And when that happens, it just lets them focus the two guys underneath. You have to go big in that instance to get a response. It is, well, let's go to the stats.
Okay.
Let's go to the stats. Marsh and his E50 all the way there in the back. 2,300, 2,000 out of Akula, 1,500 out of Germ Friction with 1,171. And so, yeah, he bounced four. Got three bounced out of almost several bounced. Mm. Just a lot of bounced shots. And you go over here for Rival. You're going to see a lot less. 2,700 to Commander J.
Wow.
2,500 out of Pride. 2,500 out of Executus. 2,000 out of Flak. 2,000 out of Pub Whisperer. And so on and so forth. And you didn't see more than three. You didn't see more than three bounces, or more than two bounces out of anybody on that team.
Yeah, from Rival.
There's one of your bigger differences. Now, you can attribute that to the positional advantages as well.
Okay.
They've got better shots. They've got less pressure. They've got
good
whatever.
Angles, yeah.
But that's what it comes down to. And if the strategy that Noble was running was rehearsed and was planned in the way that I believe it could have been and should have been, then they would have had that same comfortable room to fire, but they would have had known it.
Okay, not just like at the time go, uh-oh, like we need to start firing.
Under pressure, you're not going to see that. But we'll talk about that a little bit more as we get into the match here because it's just starting up.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's all tied up 1-1. Let's get right into it and take a look at what we've got for tanks.
For Noble with two 260s, a Batshat, two T22s, a TVP, and an RO251. Simple Tankers with two 113s, a Batshat, a 907, two T22s, and an AMX 1390. Now, so what I was getting at is they've got to know the exchanges that they're making and where they're going to get a lead, what their pick is under that kind of pressure, and what they're coming for.
Okay.
There is a chance that pushing up the hill may have been a little bit more safe. There's a lot of different things. This is something that is growing pains on a strategy when you first try it, but it's not a reason to abandon it. Go back, look at the little things, look at how you fix it, and you're in business.
Wow, right now, not a single member, I shouldn't say not a single member, but no one really from Noble going up on top of the hill. Just Friction. And then 50-51 going to that spot we kind of were praising there right at E4. A good spot where you have a lot of defense, and if things go south, you can just back right off the hill. Looks like he's going to do that right now with Sukumi. Flak and Commander J were coming to get him. Sukumi actually is going to continue to try to maybe find a shot. We'll see how far he goes as he now takes a shot from Marsh. In the RE251 being spotted out right now. He's actually going to go off the hill completely, and now it's going to be a 113 versus a 50-51. Let's see who's going to come out on top. Sukumi taking 931. One more shot, 1237. But now Friction is on reload. It's going to be up to Marsh to kind of stop what's happening as there is a battle down on the cap here. Canadian Impact taking 1422 there in that Object 260. He's got to be careful. Flak takes him down in the 113, and that is the first tank falling. Rival picking up that one. Germ looks like he'll be going down as well. Prime picking up that one. Pump Whisper finds Germ. Rival is finding kill after kill here against Noble. Finally, Milton comes back, taking down Sukumi in the bat chat. But Marsh is extremely low. Pride came up on top, trying to finish him off. It forces him off the lighthouse where Flak was there to pick him up there in that 113. Three tanks now are alive for Noble. Simple Tanker slash Rival has six. Just like that, most of Noble deleted in that fight, and now it is just Dodo, Akula, and Militant to fight against six members of Rival. It's HP-wise, 900 down, but man, tank-wise, oof.
Well, two tanks in the danger zone for Simple Tankers.
That's true, Flak and Pub.
Which bring them down to a 4v3, which would be relatively even. But Noble is on offense, so that makes it even more more slanted into Simple Tankers. It already would be because it's a 4v3, so a very tough situation for Noble. We just saw O7 play out of this, so
that's
we'll
true.
See if Noble's
hey,
got it in
yeah,
as well.
It's definitely not out of the woods yet for Noble.
You know, I'll tell you, when I was looking at teams going into playoffs and whatnot, I could see a team make huge strategic mistakes. And not saying O7 really did in that set, but I could see them throw half their tanks away and then play out of something like that. Mm. And I'd be more afraid than if they just came out and ruined the other team. Because it's like, oh, hold up. Even if things go bad for them,
they can still
play out.
Yeah.
And granted, that's, you know, fear. Whoever they play out against made mistakes. Honestly, every time you watch a World of Tanks match, WGLNA match, there are mistakes everywhere. Everybody
right.
makes
no
mistakes
game
all the time.
Perfect.
It's everything's happening so fast. You're managing six of your own teammates and seven of your opponents. It's not easy. I mean, all these guys, they absolutely destroy public matches.
Oh, sure.
Then they come in here.
That's what I can imagine.
And somebody does that to them instead. So it's no easy win at all. No easy game to play. Dotemo putting on cap pressure here in the eastern side. I don't know what those two 260s were going after for Noble diving off the cliff like that. That was a huge, huge loss of tank resources there. Dodo not putting on enough cap pressure by himself. Not that he can do any better than that. To really divert Simple Tanker's attention, they're going to go on top of the hill. Looks like most of Noble is prepared for that, aside from Akula, who is caught out quite a bit. Pride's going to get one shot at him. No, never mind. Just going to back away. Akula showing more of that individual skill play.
Whoa!
And Militant. Sorry, Dodoma taking down Flak in the 113. Akula and Militant taking on shots on top of the hill.
Come around the side, but now we have a top of the hill play. Stein Pride and Commander J surrounding Akula. Militant having a couple more shots there in that bat chat. Is going to try to do as much damage as he can, but it is not going to be enough. Akula will be going down to Commander J, leaving just Militant and Dodo. And now 2v5. Even if Dodo takes down Pub Whisper here, I just don't see Noble coming out of this one. Milton is on reload. Executus is going to have a lot of free shots onto that bat chat. Commander J is going to be able to cut him off as well. Dodo doesn't finish off Pride there. He's going to try Pub Whisper passing some shots, but Pub Whisper will be taking down Dodo. Now, if Milton can get his clip up, I mean, there are a lot of tanks that are low. Pub Whisper, Pride, he can make it a 1v3, but then he has to have three other shots, one shot tank. If he can set, if he can pull a Metalhawk, let's see. Wow, Pub Whisper going off the hill way too hard here to try to take down Milton. Milton just dodging shots left and right here. Jace Booth flying right by him, but it looks like Pride will have a shot in time. No, it's going to be Commander J. No, it's not. It's going to be, there it is. Pride takes out Milton in that bat chat, and that is going to be Rival Simple Tankers picking up their second victory against Noble there. Now, at the end, obviously, Rival feeling very confident, sending that tank off the cliff. But I mean, man, you gotta be careful.
There was no way that was intentional.
Okay. Gotcha.
It's just a hard cliff to come down.
Slowly.
It used to be easier. Now it's a lot less forgiving. And it seems like when you're full health and you drop off of it, you never take the damage. You're like, oh, cool. It's when you're down there at 50 and you're trying to be very careful that it does that.
He was like slow falling off. Yeah.
He gets the wrong edge at the wrong time. Whoops. Let's go ahead and get into those statistics.
Oh, yeah. We know you like it.
So if this were tier 8, this would look like a really good game from the left side, right?
Sure.
But it's not. So there's a problem there. 1,800 for Dodo, 1,600 for Militant, 1,500 for Akula, 1,400 for Marsh, 1,300 for Germ, 1,200 for Friction. Hmm. Over here for...
Oh, there's tier 10.
Commander J. Sorry, yeah. For Rival, Pride with 3,000. Getting back on the top. It's been a while since I felt like I read off a number like that.
Good to see it.
Commander J, 2,000. Sorry, 2,200. Pub Whisperer with 2,000. 1,600 out of Flak, 1,500, 1,600 out of Zukumi, 1,300 out of Exodus, 1,000 out of J Smooth. Now that looks
all
like a great game
all
for
team
a tier
1,000.
10. Or, yeah, tier 10.
And for a tier 8. That's a fantastic game for a tier 8. I don't know if that was possible in tier 8.
I don't know. I don't think so. I think everybody would have to be driving like KV-5s or something for that to even be remotely possible.
And then maybe,
no way I can do that math in my
and
head.
Maybe if you add, you know, shooting your teammate, your friendlies as additional damage.
Anyway, well, then, yeah, it's totally possible.
It doesn't matter because we're in tier 10 right now. So, Simple Tanker is now picking up their second victory. Noble has to come back and tie it up right now. Again, this game matters so much for both teams playing. It's got to be an intense time right now for both of them. So let's get right back into it to see if Noble can tie it up 2-2 before we leave Mines, or can Rival make it 3-1? Let's get right into it and take a look at what we've got. 4 tanks.
Noble with a 260, a Batshat, 2 T22s, a TVP, a T54, and an RU-251. Simple Tankers with an IS-7, 2 Batshats, 2 T22s, a TVP, and a Skoda T50. Not only is it important for Noble to win this match to retain their number one spot, but they need to do it authoritatively from here on out. Otherwise, they're looking at a team lower in the brackets. Not that Simple Tankers deserves to be there. They never deserve to be there, but they're frequently there, right? It happens. Okay. They have a slump in the middle of the season. They bring it back at some point. Very consistent thing. Noble cannot look weak against them, or it's going to eliminate a lot of that fear factor going into the playoffs, and it's everything. Pub Whisper getting absolutely lit up, and Exodus from an early volley from Noble as Simple Tankers try and take the hill.
There's the punishment we talk about if you're on Mines, to punish the enemy from taking the hill if you're not going to take it yourself. Pub Whisper now below half health in his bad chat, but both him and Exodus are up on top. Between the two of them, they have 10 shots. I mean, that's a lot of damage.
It's not a huge loss for Simple Tankers overall. Pub needs to be careful. That's it. But they still have Exodus to do whatever they needed a full health Batshat to do. He's not quite full, but he's close enough. They have the top of the hill control, and I would say it was a relatively fair cost to pay. Now, that changes things a little bit
that
here as J Smooth getting lit up by Canadian Impact's 260. What I was saying before, though, is Rival did a good amount of damage to Friction and Germ on their way up, and they took not quite equal, but a fair amount of damage on Pub Whisperer. With J Smooth taking that amount, it now obviously tilts into Simple Tanker's favor, or sorry, Simple Tanker's lower health pool, with Noble having the advantage there. Noble's favorite. Coffee Thief taking another shot
from Marsh there.
And a little bit of hill stagnation here. And Noble is very pushed up. They're all in on this one. You can see they're already taking preventative measures against what happened last time. They moved Germ out of that eastern spot underneath the hill to watch for what's coming. The 260 is playing further up. Now, there's only one of them as well, because they decided they only needed one. And they're going to take the other one into a medium so they get a little bit more mobility. Then you look back, and the E50, sorry, they have no... Am I losing my mind? I just noticed this. Germ's in a T54, and Marsh is in an RU-251.
Yeah.
They're playing a point down. Am I crazy?
Oh, really? Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh. Somebody readied up in the wrong tank.
Oh.
Wow, that is not good.
Wow, that's the first time we've seen this.
That's real bad. I'll put it that way. I mean, that could be a T62A. It could be a 907. It could be all sorts of better things than that. Or the RU-251 could be an E50 again or something. I don't know. You can see all the different adjustments that Noble made here. They got Militant drop back here in a much better place for a Batshat to come in with that late damage. Marsh is washing the western side. I can't even fathom it. A reason why they would take a T-54 over the Tier 10 version.
If you bring the T-54 over the Tier 10, it's actually, and they beat Rival. This is exactly what you talked about. I mean, you need to look authoritative as you go into playoffs.
Trust me, no matter what happens from here, it won't look authoritative.
Oh.
That is not a kind of mistake you want to be showing at any
sure,
point.
I'm trying to give them the benefit of the doubt.
I see. I take these things a lot more seriously than most people do. A lot of them look at it and be like, they made one mistake, but they're still a great team, right? I like to try and spin this into positive morale for the team when I played other people. Mm. So I look at these kinds of things as huge sound bites to latch onto. Be like, come on, man. That one time they brought a Tier 9? Like, come on. How organized could they be, right? Trying to take away people's fear.
Gotcha.
So it's just a message that they don't need. Granted, is it going to lose them a game on its own? No. Well, it might make them lose this game. But I'm not I'm talking about the playoffs and the finals. So we're getting ready for a counter push from Noble with a very awkward fight coming up here. And Canadian Impact taking 788.
Starting it off not too good. Looking at that Object 260 now. 1460, 1835. Jace Booth going to finish him off. But Dodo does find Flak in response to an IS-7 there going down for Simple Tankers. That's two tanks down for Noble. And now Exeggis finds a kill. Kula takes down Pub Whisper. Now it is a 6 or 5-on-5 between both these teams. The hill battle has commenced. Dodo finds Exeggis, and now Hill Control actually going over to Noble, but Commander J saying, nope, not gonna let that happen. Taking down Marsh in the RU-251. Now Milton, one more shot away in that batch yet. He has got to be careful or he will be falling. He has one more shot to get out. Let's see if he will do it safely or if he'll be going down for it. Coffee Thief takes down Friction there in that 50-51. Now just three tanks on the side of Noble against the four for Rival, but Pride might be going down here. One more shot away. Milton just barely dodging a shot. Looks like they're from Pride. Akula taking down Pride in that T-22. Jace Booth now wrapping around in that Skoda T-50. He's got three of his shots. Dodo getting very low in that T-22. One more shot from the back, and it looks like that's exactly what Jace Booth is trying to do, and he'll be going down here. They're just buying time for Milton to be reloaded. He is almost there. He is about 80% done. He will be ready to start joining this fight again. Let's see if he can turn the tides because
Coffee
Noble
Thief
is not looking good.
He's lined up for it, and he is waiting for Militant to make that poke. But Coffee Thief just got spotted, so Militant is not going to take that risk.
All right, we'll see if Commander J can do something here. He's going to go over the side. Jace Booth just sitting back, being patient. So he has the utmost confidence in his team to be able to deal.
If he just waits for Jay Smooth and Coffee Thief comes up to support Commander J, they can bring it home fairly easily here.
They're doing it right now. There it is, the move from Coffee, the move from Jay Smooth at the time. But no, Militant takes down Jay Smooth. It is now a 3-on-2. Coffee Thief is getting focused down as well. Militant is starting to come around to join the fight. Akula takes down Coffee Thief. It is now a 2v1. Commander J has 2 one-shot tanks to take care of. There's one, but Militant in the autoloader might have enough damage to take down Commander J. One more shot, he'll do it, but Commander J is loaded. Who will it be? Will it be Noble? Will it be Rival? It comes down to this final shot. It's Commander J taking down Milton, and Rival is going to pick up their third victory here against Noble. What is it with these close battles tonight? Such good play coming out from both these teams, but man, what a pick out there.
I'll say this. I am super critical of anybody who has been in the league as long as Commander J. I expect great things for them. Great game, Jay. Great game. So many different things going on there. Coffee Thief. So, little pro tip. Coffee Thief got spotted there while camping Militant's position, right? Best thing to do in that situation? Well, nah, I take it back. Maybe it's not the best thing to do. I'm going to throw the pro tip out there anyways. In a public match, if you get spotted and you know it's somebody from a bush like that, just send the shot anyways. You'll probably get it.
Okay.
In that instance, it probably would have been a big risk because if he had missed,
Milton would have
poked out and hit him.
Yeah,
so actually, good job there. Let's go into stats.
Oh, what a battle.
Timeout from Noble.
Makes sense.
Commander J, 2,800 damage. 2,600 for J Smooth, 1,800 for Exeggis, 1,600 for Pride, 1,600 for Pub Whisperer. Crazy game.
Wow.
3,700 for Dodo.
Oh, Dodo.
How much more can you do? Right?
You can't. You just can't do much more than that.
3,000 for Militant. And honestly, he did the best that he could right there. If you're in a corner battle and one tank's a T-22 and the other's a Bat Chat and you have one shot, and you know Commander J knows it, how can you win? I mean, you have to get lucky and Commander J has to mess up for you to get that shot opportunity because he can hit the corner of your turret. You can't do that to him. Because then you're reloading for however. Like,
right. So that's so true.
Anyway, sorry. Going on a rant here. 3,000 for Militant.
We have time.
2,300 for Friction. 2,000 for Akula. And yeah, that T-54 coming back. I mean, just how many hit points would that have been?
Oh. Well done. Well done for Rival for kind of coming out of that one. Looking at the kind of the overall flow of the battle, was it more often in Noble's hands than more often in Rival's hands?
It was more often in Rival's hands, and there were some significant mistakes. There's a great brawl from Noble in the middle for a little bit, but also many, many failures there. Actually, I saw something I want to go back and look at.
Okay,
so it didn't end up mattering. I saw Pride show up late, and that the whole reason why that fight was even anywhere close is because Pride was in rotation at the time.
Around the entire?
Rival was doing a smart way. They were only going to send one tank because they were expecting that counter push middle. Hmm. So they're going to send one tank around to queue it and then trap it. It just happened at a weird time for them, and they're like, wait, we're not ready.
No, that was
why. Why would you push when you're down and in a bad position with a tier 9 instead of a tier 10? Like, I get why that's super confusing to Rival and why they might not be ready for it at that moment to hit the shots they needed to hit. They still brought it out. But it really is
a
just...
landslide.
Pride showed up late, and he's trying to catch up. And he sent a shot, and I thought he shot one of his own bad shots. The tracer was in line. It may have gone over, or it may have already died.
Oh, that would.
But
been,
I was like, oh, that would have been a problem. That's gonna be problematic.
So this actually brings a good point. When we talk about these brawls, we see a lot of these brawls here, and it's just mass chaos. How common is it to see friendly fire?
I don't know. I mean, most statistics are made up on the spot, right? So we're gonna go with. 10% of the time, 5% of the time.
So 5 to 10% of the time.
Let's go with 3% of the time.
All right, so 3% of the time, guys, roughly when you see those brawls is when you see some friendly fire coming on the team. So keep that in mind, 3%.
It happens. It certainly happens. Now, what happens far more often is people actually shooting a dead tank.
Oh, because most people like, want to get
it down.
They all shot
at the same time.
Right. So one takes it down, the other two just... there should be a statistic for that. Ladies and gentlemen, right now we're going into Steps. Rival is up 3-1 against Noble. Let's get right into it and take a look at what we've got for our tanks.
You know, you're onto something with that. Noble with an E5, a Bat Shadow 140, two T22s, a T54, and an M53, M55. Simple Tankers with an E5, two 140s, an STB, two T22s, and an RE251. If you could track teams, not just individuals, but team, which tracking individuals would lead to team, yes. If you could track team shots onto dead tanks,
yeah,
you would very, very quickly be able to differentiate between teams you would and would not want to brawl with.
Huh.
Because it's a hallmark of communication. We worked on it a lot. We had all sorts of codes that you use
like
when
can
you're
finish
reloading
it off? Can you finish it off?
Or getting a kill shot on stuff.
Yeah.
And we always had it one person call the kill shot, and ideally the second person would call essentially the backup, and everybody else would peel off target.
Wow.
Because you had redundancy.
Wow, that's great.
But it didn't always work that way. Usually it was just everybody calling at the same time, and the first guy who called it shoots, and that's it.
So what I'll do...
Militant getting caught out.
Oh, no.
We already saw this once before. How is this happening again? Militant's going to have to get away as Simple Tankers are going to try and pounce on this. And Noble is further in the south, going to try and get return fire, but they may back off a little bit too early. Simple Tankers are going to maybe fumble this, but there goes Militant.
There it is.
Down early in the battle.
That's
twice.
Rival also on defense.
Oh.
They pick this up. That's four.
Wait, it wasn't them. It was High Voltage that happened to.
Was it Thursday?
Yes.
Yes, you're right.
Sorry, Noble.
Sorry, Militant.
Wasn't saying again as in you did it again, but we saw this again. All right, whatever. Either way, big loss for Noble.
But hey.
And they're already down two games.
But hey.
This is rough territory. J-Smooth getting a little bit of fire and a lot of cap pressure going out on the eastern side.
Noble's just going to try to go. They know they're a tank down. J-Smooth might be going down as well. That could be the scout falling for Rival, but he gets down the hill just in time. 27 seconds now on the clock. Now, did we kind of talk about this cap as in you want to pull them over, but do not die for it because there's so many weird places to fight. Let's see if Noble does that. A lot of shots go on to Coffee Thief. Only one connecting. The cap dropping out of 16 seconds. If Simple Takers can pick this up, they will go 4-1 against Noble, and that is something Noble does not want. They're going to try to stop it, and their first focus is going to be Executus taking 1,000 points of damage. Only 13 from Marsh. That could have been a kill there coming out from that artillery, but unfortunately just not close. close enough. Commander Jam, Help Whisper now going up against Dodo. 622, they're going to that T22. Noble giving up on the cap pressure. They just need to win this fight right now. What is going to be a tough hill to come back here onto Steps. Germ taking 691 there from Pride. So much damage coming out from both these teams. The HP, though, only about within a thousand of each other. Simple Tankers is up on top of that, but with Friction taking down Jace Move, that is the first tank falling for the side of Noble. Coffee Thief takes down Friction. Simple Tankers loses Pub Whisper to Dodoma. Germ takes down Pride. Commander J finds Germ. It is now a 4-on-4. Noble doing a great job here in the brawl, starting to come back. Coffee Thief, though, finds Dodoma at T22, and they are now collapsing down onto Canadian Impact. 11:42, they're going to that E5. A shot from the back, actually bouncing, but it's not going to matter. Coffee Thief finishes off Canadian Impact, and now it is just Akula and Marsh. I was just going to say, it's a 2-on-3. You know, it was a 3-on-4, a 4-on-4, but I totally forgot that Noble has an artillery, which is definitely a clutch here in this brawl. Commander J taking his shot there, driving in, going to take down this T22. There's a shot. Oh, no, waiting for it, making sure he can find it. There's a 337, a nice shot from Fleck to get it ready for Akula, and now it is just Marsh left. And that M53, M55 artillery,
man,
no match.
When Commander J was playing for Noble, a lot of the time I felt like he was sitting back when he shouldn't be. He was so far in up that brawl this time around.
Huh.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Crazy. So many great plays.
Well done.
Coming out from Commander J in this set so far. Now, I don't know. Maybe this is hard to remember, because I don't do it that often. And sorry, I don't mean to gloss over the fact that Simple Tankers is now 4-1 over Noble.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
You know what? I didn't do it to High Voltage. I'm not going to do it to Noble either. I can't kick him. Well, I can't kick him about the artillery while they're down like this. Now, if they come back and win, oh, it's open season. Let's go into the stats.
Oh no, I did that. Oh no, I'm so sorry, Noble.
3,500. That's why I was laughing. 3,500 at a Coffee Thief. Wow. He's usually not one of the ones you'd expect to put up a whole lot. Great job of him. Oh, yeah. he was the one that was with Commander J during that fight, and I remember seeing their two gameplay being stellar.
Battle
and this
moves.
This usually I remember this being the other way around, where it would be somebody would be taking the initial shots and playing forward, and Commander J would get all the damage. But this time, Commander J was in the T22, so he knew he could bounce, so he went.
Wow.
Sorry,
well
3,500 for Coffee Thief, 2,500 for Commander J, 2,000 for Flak, 1,700 for Pub Whisperer, and so on and so forth. For Noble, 2,400 for Impact, 2,200 for Akula, 1,800 for Dodoma, and everybody else below even 1,200 there. Although Germ just barely touching that. So what I'm trying to get at, it's not rehashing of old criticisms of Jay. What I'm trying to say is he's really blowing my mind right now with
well
he is playing.
Well done, Commander Jay. And again, Rival, again, like you reiterate, 4-1 right now against Noble. So in this next, now we will be seeing a Rival on offense on the step, so Noble will be on defense. So they have a good chance of picking up this victory and keeping it alive. Let's see if they can, or will Rival pick up their fifth and final victory? Again, crucial game for both these teams. Let's go right into it and take a look at what we've got. Four tanks.
Somewhere, Simp and the rest of, well, sorry, Drynitz and the rest of Simp are sitting there just like, go, Rival, get him. Because they would take first if this happens. Noble with an E5 and Batchat, 2 140s, 2 T22s, and an RU251. Simple Tankers with 2 140s and 907, and STB, 2 T22s, and an RU251 of their own. They're not playing any sort of slower game here. They're playing it fast. They have no Batchat at all.
Line up v line up. Who'd you rather be right now?
I'd rather be Noble.
Okay. All right. So Noble.
I'd rather be Noble.
In your mind, having a good chance of holding this defense. Maybe
it is a defensive thing, though. Holy
what,
Rival.
What is this move?
This is so meta. This is the time to break out that crazy stuff. Remember I said Simple Tankers?
Oh,
here
there
they go.
It is.
They're coming in hot, and Militant takes 647.
Simple Tankers driving right across the side to cut off Noble, take it to him head-to-head, and they want to win this brawl right now for their fifth victory. Let's see if they can do it. Militant luckily making out of there. That was very close to that Batchat going down. And now Simple Tankers over here right in the base of Noble, right where they spawn. Very close to cap. Let's see what happens now. So kind of the initial shock, the initial jump is up. So with them not picking up a tank there, that's is that I mean, now Rival, they are just kind of now a head-to-head against Noble.
If they got a plan from here, they could be in business. But if that was their whole plan, they're going to get ruined over time from the superior positions of Noble, as Noble guaranteed fell back from that. And the surprise factor is dissipating. For a while, I guarantee you, Noble was very, very rustled by that and pretty scared. But now, as time goes on, they're calming down. They've got their defensive positions. And they're feeling a lot better about it.
All right, there. So possibly a surprise attack from Rival, just not getting what they looked for. Coffee Thief going to an interesting position there in that 140. Maybe trying to find some angles on the rest of Noble. Getting lit up and taking a shot there from one of these three members that you guys can see on your screen from Noble. Canadian Impact taking a little bit of damage, but not too much. Another shot coming on Coffee Thief. Dodo taking some. But now we have the two RU251 starting to separate from the team. Let's see what these scouts can do to start making a play here. Interesting. HP-wise, Noble is up. More than 800. Great job as far as HP goes. So yeah, so it looks like Rival was just looking for a certain pick that just did not get.
He almost had it with Militant.
Almost had it.
And I'm not sure who got all those spots, if it was Militant or somebody else, but if nobody had gone up on one of those ridges to get a little bit of vision over the flat, Noble would have been in a boatload of trouble. I think Simple Tankers took the wrong vector. They should have been cutting off the north from Noble. Basically treating it as though Noble was on cap, but they took the shortest vector possible and ended up just bottling themselves into an aggressive Eastern fight, but still pretty a standard fight there. J-Smooth getting absolutely lit up as Marsh is defended. If J-Smooth was able to take out Marsh, it could have opened up a lot of options. Simple Tanker still in business here, but they are down 2,000 hit points.
All right here, and continuing to fall. 5 minutes just about to go through. Canadian Impact taking another shot. There it is, Milton finishes off J-Smooth in his bat chat. This now allows Marsh and the RU251 to start possibly wrapping around Simple Tankers, getting in some nice shots in the back. And it looks like, yeah, it's just all falling apart before our eyes for Rival. But a really fun attempt, very aggressive play coming out from them on offense. Try to just mix it up, do something we've never seen before.
There's a lot to talk about what could have happened in that instance. We don't have the time now, but there was a lot more thought in that than it probably looked like to begin with. Just not quite enough to guarantee they could convert it into a win in all circumstances.
All right, so now Simple Tankers, I'm guessing, just hoping that Noble makes a mistake here, puts a tank in a position where they can find and get a pick. A little bit of damage there going into a cool in the T22. Pride just rocking back and forth, taking those shots right once they're off reload. Again, you're talking about the T22, a great tank for that. Just as you're moving, you can just take those shots pretty accurately. Here comes the possible try and last ditch effort for Rival to get out of this. They're going to collapse down upon Germ. He might be going down here. He's got to be careful. Commander J taking the first bit of damage, but he is leading the charge for Rival. And now they are surrounding him, actually kind of going right by him. Coffee Thief in the 140 is going to start supplying covering fire from over on the hill. Germ getting lit up. 915 going to the 140. One more shot from Pub Whisper. Actually, Executives picks him up, but Dodo takes down Flack to respond. Now Executives will be going down. 756 in that SCV-1. Dodo finds him as well. A double kill coming out from that T22. And Canadian Impact takes down Pride. Pub Whisper will be going down here to Friction. Commander J does find Militant, but there is just two members on the side of Simple Tanker's Rival. And Sick 5 on the side of Noble. Commander J will be going down here to Dodo. That's three kills for Dodo on this match. And Noble is going to keep it alive here on this sixth battle, making it 2-4 against Rival here as Coffee Thief, the last remaining member. Bouncing a lot of shots in that 140, but not enough from Canadian Impact. There we go. So Noble have two. If they can find another one, it's three. If they can find another one, it's tied. But again, Rival just needs one more, but a great kind of reaction, a great early spot, like you were saying, from someone from Noble. You didn't really know who it was, but to make sure that they saw all the members of Rival coming out over the hill, and like, guys, get out, get back, get out. So I'm excited to kind of see what you break that one down to.
Let's get into the stats first, then.
Let's do it.
Commander J with 2,000, Coffee Thief with 2,000, 1,500 at a Pub Whisper, and everybody else falling below that. For Noble, 3,300. Out of Akula, Dodo with 1,900 on that. Canadian Impact with about 1,800 on his own. Marsh wasn't the one who got the spotting. He threw in about 1,700 in an RU251. 1,500 out of Friction, and it is Militant indeed.
Militant. He was the one who got spotted.
If it weren't for his spidey senses,
Wow.
That would have been a totally different game.
Six members.
Totally different
Six
game. But look at this. Great damage spread overall and a lot of positional play coming out from Noble there. Now, Simple Tankers could have done that lower road push a little bit earlier. And had they really focused and hit their shots coming around, it could have been a very different fight. If you come around that area and you pick the first tank that's there, because there will be one watching,
okay.
It's actually more of a problem if a tank is further back, like all the way against the A-line, to where he can spot down into it, but he's not in the bowl
so
area.
So like, you get spotted and then don't
you get
have
spotted
the shots.
And he leaves.
Yeah.
And then if you try and go up and over, all the other guys can shoot at you. That's actually a far more frustrating place to be. And it's not too much of a positional loss. So where Germ was a big risk.
Wow.
Simple Tankers could have gotten that, pulled back, handled all the adjustments that would be happening while Coffee Thief and the other fallback guy gotten a lot of damage. Very close. Little things in all different points of that map, and that could have been a Simple Tankers win, but Noble kept it together, and they brought it back out.
All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, Noble trying to keep it alive. Rival just needing one more victory. They are now on defense. Let's see if they can find it. Or can Noble make it 3-4? Let's get right into it and take a look at what we've got.
Four tanks. Noble with an E5, two 140s, two T22s, a TVP, and an RU51. Simple Tankers with an E5, two 140s, an STB, two T22s, and an RU51 as well. Now Simple Tankers are on defense, and the onus is on Noble to bring this match into the win column, or they will lose for a full 3 points and surrender their first seed into the finals.
A big battle for Noble indeed, and also a big one for Simple Tankers. Rival to pick this one up. Again, just before this match,
they're boosting.
This battle continues.
If there was ever a time to boost, it is now. As long as they know they can get their resets, having somebody up there to guarantee they win that Eastern fight, this is a rough, rough place for Noble to be in. And with no artillery for them right now,
Yeah.
It's hard to break. They have to get through that E5 somehow. And this is traditionally something we haven't seen people really do reliably without an artillery to break it down. Granted, the last time they ran the artillery, it did not work for them. So we will see here.
Seems like
so far, Simple Tankers playing a great meta game overall. Good instincts, slight adjustments, and they would be done with this match already.
Already, Rival starting to take those shots onto the boost position over the north of the railroad tracks. You guys see Pride with those in the T22, just making sure that if Noble were doing that, they would be taking a lot of damage for it. Canadian Impact being spotted out in that E5 there. He's got to be careful. It does seem that Noble took a lot more cautious response to the north after what happened to them last time.
Yes, and they didn't bring the artillery because of what the potential flex could have been from Simple Tankers that time. Definitely don't play an artillery twice, right?
Right.
I mean, it just makes it too easy to pick apart.
As we are seeing. And again, just because my mind, I'm not going to be able to forget about it until it goes away. Rival, what they just tried against Noble when they were on offense, the scout battle that could have been won for Rival. If that would have happened, that would have changed a lot of things. So still very close. But this is the battle that is at hand, ladies and gentlemen. Again, Rival just needing one more victory.
Oh, wow. The meta is real. There is so much flexing into the south right now to try and get picks here for Noble, for Simple Tankers. They either know that Friction cannot escape if pressed, granted he is very difficult to get, or they've got some sort of trick up their sleeve. But Friction is actually going to be in a fantastic position to punish Rival for every step of this play.
Oh, man. And here's the thing. If Noble can come back and pick up this one, then they're going to be on defense, a pretty good position to pick up another one. Dodo, though, getting spotted out, taking over 600 points of damage in that T22, as a lot of the members, six members for Simple Tankers. Rival is starting to pressure down the south. This should call Noble to start putting on cap pressure, and it's just going to be up to Jace move to get the resets. Rival now starting to chase. We've seen with this kind of backfires of a lot of teams here going to the center. Exec is taking 704. They're chasing Dodo. They want to take down that T22. He actually gets behind the rock, which is going to mean Rival possibly should be putting the brakes, but they're not. They're just going to keep going. They know that Dodo's low, and they want to take him down. And this is going to be a Pub Whisper actually taking the shot a little too early, but it's not going to matter as Commander J. He's going to pick up that one. Actually, Pride picked up that kill. That is the first takedown falling for Noble. Let's see what they can do to respond. Canadian Impact taking 1,200 points of damage. Milton takes down Executus. A one-for-one exchange here, but Canadian Impact is extremely low. Marsh takes down Coffee Thief, and that is two takes now down. Noble trying to claw the way back from this one, and they are doing well at it as Pride, though, taking a lot of damage. 611 in the T22. Commander J takes down Middleton. Canadian Impact taking a shot from Jay Smooth from the back. Akua finds Pride. Flak finds Canadian Impact. This is it. This is Noble's last chance to pick up this victory. They need to take down these remaining three members of Simultankers, or they are giving up their number one seed. Pub Whisper goes down, and it looks like they're going to do it. They're going to hold on. They're going to keep it alive. Akula might be going down, but they're still going to have three members to take down just the two of Simultankers. Flak takes down Akula there. It is now a 3-on-2, though, in favor still of Noble. Marsh actually getting pretty low there. A lot of bounce shots coming out from him. Flak takes down Marsh, and now Simultankers and Rival, or Simultankers and Noble are tied up 2-2. But with that tank going down, Germ picking up a kill. It is now a 2v1. Friction fully loaded in that 50-51 is just gonna rip Commander J apart. There's his final shot going in there. Actually, looks like he decided to clip before he did it. It's gonna be up to Commander J and Germ. If Commander J can bounce some shots there, no, Germ takes it down. Noble keeps it alive, picking up their third victory there against Simultanker Rivals, getting close, but finding the victory here, and now going to be on defense, going to have a good chance to keep it, to tie it up, and then going into a tiebreaker. So not over yet from Noble, not over yet at all. Whew. Dave, you want to get into some stats, and then I can ask you some questions?
Yep.
Let's do it.
Still recovering. 3,700 at Commander J. 1,900 out of Pub Whisperer, 1,800 out of Flak, and everybody else is really where all this kind of falls down. Just bad shooting in a lot of instances, just not hitting their targets, trying to hit things on the move, probably not using auto-aim, because honestly, on the move, right-click, left-click is very, very great. Depends on the tank, though, and only one T20, sorry, oh no, sorry, one T22, Pride, okay, I'm not going to nitpick here. We go over here for Noble, 3,600 from German, 3,000,
wow.
Or 2,900 from Friction. Him coming in late is what solved everything.
Really?
Two of his clips were game-changing clips.
Wow.
And that is his position. And he played it, well. Did bounce three times, but not anything super critical that I saw. Canadian Impact with about 2,100, 1,700 out of Akula, 1,600 out of Militant. So just absolutely neck and neck brawl that whole time around.
Oh.
I could turn around and pick off different tanks that didn't cover well enough, that didn't do whatever.
Okay.
And really, strategically, positionally, Rival did so many great things by not stopping as they moved down the middle, moving all the way and taking the ridge back, picking off Militant. So many good things. If they had gotten that kill on the E5, it would have been a different game completely.
Yeah.
And then everybody, once they got the E5, the problem was they became so focused on killing it that they let Friction drive across the open.
Yeah.
Had they gotten the E5 and Militant, they would have had bird's eye view on Friction driving a TVP up the middle. They would have dropped him, and it would have been game over for Rival. As it is right now, It is now not quite do or die.
Like getting closer than
Rival,
but it is
Noble. But Noble is on defense now, and that's a much harder proposition. But given how close it was last time, who knows?
All right. Well, one thing I was going to say at the end there, when Dota was being chased up, the rest of Rival sending six of their members to try to take him down up the center road. They didn't kill him in time. He got behind a rock, and I was thinking, well, last time that Rival did this and pushed at the center, they got punished for it, so they're probably going to stop. They didn't. They pushed on the way through, but didn't stop in the middle like you kind of praised them for. Found those tanks, found the damage, but Noble did a great job in the brawl. So now we are getting right into the next battle. Noble, ladies and gentlemen, on defense. If they hold this, they go into a tiebreaker. It's really Simultankers, another chance they have to pick up a victory. Can they do it right now? Or will Noble stop them? Let's get right into it and take a look at what we got for tanks.
For Noble, trying to hold on for dear life, an E5, a Batshat, two 140s, two T22s, and an RE251. Yeah. Four Simultankers, two 113s, two 140s, two T22s, and an AMX 1390.
Again, both of these teams, this battle holds so much for both of these teams to win. I just can't even imagine just the amount of tension on Simultankers, on Noble right now.
Absolutely. I can't imagine it. I'd rather not.
Marsh
gonna get his boost.
Uh-oh. Oh, that boost might spell the end because Rival is starting to go over the east.
Yeah, they're going to do it twice. And if they come pouring, if they knew what was up right now, this would be so game over for Noble, but they're going to know soon enough, as a lot of these positions are not going to be spotted. And they see Militant taking a lower ground position. He is brilliantly trying to spot the bottom to guarantee Simultankers couldn't come around and catch a lot of Noble unawares. If Simultankers is able to take a lot of the positions they need, they could be in business. But now that Marsh is on top of the hill, it is a lot safer for them, and they're starting to flow into those positions. Simultankers have gone faster. This could have been their game.
Oh, right now, time might have been the enemy. There's the first shot coming up from Marsh on top of the hill. Executives popping over, taking a lot of damage. Milton again taking most of the shots from Civil Tank Arrivals. 1275, but this time he actually might be going down. But Pride, 1402, who will go down first? Will it be a member of Noble? Will it be a member of Rival? Pub Whisper takes down Milton. Taking down that Bash Head, that is a tank already falling for Noble, but German is going to respond by taking down Pride in the 140. Exec is now getting surrounded by German Friction. A couple more shots in that T22. He'll be going down. Germ taking some damage as well. And there it is, Dodo finding Executives. Noble doing their best to try to hold on, to take this victory, to tie it up against Rival. Let's see what Rival can do to stop them as Flak takes 691. 1440 in that 130, and Marsh from on top of the hill, raining those shots down in the RE251. Such a beautiful place to be for him. Commander J trying to find Friction, who is low, taking the shot, 699 to J Smooth. Commander J does find Friction, but with Akula finding J Smooth, there is just three tanks for Rival, five for Noble, and it looks like, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be going into a tiebreaker here for our third match of the night, leading into playoffs. Coffee Thief and Commander J are all that is left for Rival. Commander J does find Germ, but it is not what shouldn't be enough, I should say. We have seen some crazy things happen tonight with Canadian Impact taking down Coffee Thief. That is going to seal the deal for Noble. Commander J knows there's nothing that he can do right now. He's just turning. There it is. The explosion going through, and we're going to be seeing, ladies and gentlemen, a tiebreaker between Noble and Rival. An incredible victory coming out from them. Incredible comeback. They were down 1-4 against Rival, coming back on steps, really showing their dominance on that map. And now, you know what the tiebreaker map is? Which is, I don't think I've seen either of these teams play it. It's Sand River. So we're going to be seeing Sand River, ladies and gentlemen, for this tiebreaker battle. And Noble getting word that they are going to be the ones to pick offense or defense. Woo!
Let's get into the stats.
Check it out.
Terrible shooting from Simple Tankers overall. And Noble, with that tie, has now clinched first place.
They got that point. Wow! Well done! Congrats! Just in the nick of time. Woo!
Pub Whisper with 2,400. Commander J with 2,1700 out of Coffee Thief. And that's pretty much it. Just a lot of awkward fighting for Simple Tankers there. And now for Noble, 3,300 out of Akula, 3,200 out of Canadian Impact, 2,100 out of Germ, Dodomo with 1,800, Marsh with 1,700 reigning from on top there, and Friction and Militant down below. There, while they didn't get a lot of damage, what Militant and Friction were hugely important in that match. Friction rounding, pulling around and pick off Pride, I think it was is seriously important. And again, it just comes down to a big fight where Simple Tankers couldn't make up their mind to whether they were pushing or not. Okay. And they missed those kill shots on Militant like three times.
Yeah.
And trying to get the kill shot, just like the E5 from last game, trying to get it, cost them thousands of hit points.
Yep. So there you guys go. Do not, just don't overcommit, I guess. But again, in those battles, they see those tanks, they want to take them down, probably hoping that it was worth it, and just didn't work out for them in that situation. Noble, congratulations for locking up first place. Now a guaranteed, well, I mean, they were guaranteed by going into the finals, so we won't be seeing them for the playoffs, but we'll be seeing them in Las Vegas for the finals. So congratulations to them. So now it's going to be Simp are the ones who are going to be, if let's say Simple Tankers win this, so they're going to get 2 points. Is that going to really change anything for them? Is this kind of like a nice happy medium for both the teams? Like, oh, we got a tiebreaker and Simple Tankers won.
If Simple Tankers get 2 points, that ties them with Caller Wanted, I believe. And Simple Tankers lost to Caller Wanted, so then they would be sixth.
Okay.
So if they lose this, they're then tied with AM60 and 07. And that makes Simple Tankers sixth.
You know that scene from The Beautiful Mind where it's just like,
yes. Okay. So no matter what, Simple Tankers is sixth now.
Oh, all right. Well, hey, so I mean, tiebreaker for both of them seems like a pretty good pretty good win for both teams. So congratulations for both of your teams for making the playoffs. Noble for being in first. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, the tiebreaker battle to decide who is the victor of this match is about to be underway. It is Noble on defense on Sand River, Simple Tankers on offense. Let's get right into it and take a look at what we've got for tanks.
Noble with an E5, two bad shots, two T22s, and two T54s. Simple Tankers with two E5s, two bad shots, two T22s,
artillery.
And an M40, M43.
Artillery on offense. Let's see if it works out for him. Again, I don't think I've seen either of these teams on Sand River, so I'm interested to see what their strategy is. Maybe these are some crazy awesome
essentially, essentially, the change here is an E5 and an M40, M43 versus two T54s. That's the difference.
Okay, okay. We'll see what this map favors. We'll see the positions of both these teams favor. So now Commander Jace, Pride, both being spotted there. Bouncing some shots, bouncing another shots. Gosh, the T22. It ceases to amaze me with the amount of shots that go into it and the non-existent damage that comes out of it. I mean, out of the shots that go into it. And they're starting to push up there, being very aggressive, going right here for the northern cap. Now proxy spotting a lot of the members for Noble, so they see him. This might be what Executives is looking for. Maybe start letting those shots fly in the artillery. We'll see what goes down from here. Looking at the positions so far between between both these teams, are you sort of thinking you're like going to praise Rival 4 doing? Is something pretty standard we see on the Sand River for both these guys?
It's hard to call any of this standard right now because neither of these teams have played this map yet. Executives did miss a long shot here in the dunes. He will have to reposition to get a better angle. But overall, Noble's actually playing a fairly flexible defense, which is new. We haven't seen that much. And Simple Tankers are playing a more conventional offense. So while Noble does have some weakness in these overall positions, they could be breaking out of that right now as ex-soldier and Germ are going to push down and probably run into Coffee Thief.
Oh, they're also digging some nice shots there onto Pride. 321 going at him from Akula. There you guys go see a Bat Chat and T-54 chasing down Coffee Thief in his Bat Chat. He is turning and running. Not sure he'll be able to run too far, though. I'm going to keep our eyes right there on that. Commander J trying to help out. X-Shoulder actually taking a shot. 359 from him. Coffee Thief taking 421. And now Akula, Dodo, and Marsh setting up for Noble, doing a lot of damage onto Jay Smooth as he tries to get closer to join the rest of his team. But now a little bit of flex coming out from Rival to start doing the damage onto Marsh from the back. 838 going at him. Jay Smooth, though, getting low as well. Both members on both these teams shots away from going down. It's Pride taking a lot of damage there. 1,085, 308 going into that T22. One more shot. Marsh is going to finish him off. And that is the first tank fallen for Rival Simple Tankers. And now Commander Jay taking on Marsh in response to that T54 gone. T54 for a T22, though. Still a good exchange there coming out for Noble, and Germ picks up Jay's move right there. Meanwhile, Flak and Canadian Impact going head-to-head in their E5s. Canadian coming out a little more wounded from that battle than Flak was. 366. Pub Whisperer going to come join him. He's going to try to block some shots, though. Maybe go for... No, not a ram. I thought he was going to go for a ram there in that bat chat, but his shot is going to be up. It doesn't matter. Flak is going to take down Canadian. It is now a 5-on-5, but as Akula takes down Flak, it is now a 5-on-4. In favor for Noble. Dodo has to be careful on that T22. He is one or maybe two shots away. Commander J taking a lot of damage. X-Shoulder picks him off. Pup Whisper takes down Akula. Noble still staying in the lead, but just barely. Pup Whisper, though, with that 1199 in the bat chat, is going to increase that HP lead by only actually 200 between both these teams, because X-Soldier is one more shot away from going down, but Germ and Dodo are not going to let Pub Whisper get out of their sight. Germ picks up that tank. Wow.
If they had rammed,
yeah.
What would have happened?
Yeah.
I don't know. I've never attempted to ram a T22 with a bat shot.
Why not? It sounds amazing.
I couldn't tell you the tonnage of the T22 off the top of my head, but once we get out of this match, we can probably figure it out.
All right, but Noble having four members against the two of Simple Tankers. Noble looking good to pick this one up.
How many tons do you think the bat shot is?
Not enough.
It's in the name.
Oh, 22?
22. It's the T22.
Oh, yeah.
It's
yeah.
The 25.
Oh,
I thought 25.
Oh, I thought it was yeah. The T is for tons.
Yep.
Not for tanks.
Just like the AMX 50B is roughly 50 tons.
It's not the Bat Chat 25 tank. That's not what the T stands for? The T54 is not the tank 54?
Don't think so. But what do I know? I mean, it's French.
The T-22, the Tank 22? I'm thinking there's a theme here, David.
Christian, you know I don't speak Spanish.
Even old Will Ferrell and me. Right there, 3 minutes and 25 seconds. I'm excited to see Executus. Oh, wow. Copy Thief finishes off X-Soldier there in his bat chat. Nice little pickup there. We kind of got a head-to-head between him and Militant. Militant has one more shot in, but it is... No, two more shots, so he should probably will be... No, Copy Thief has it up just in time, but Germ does finish off Copy Thief. It is now Executus versus two... Wait, what? Did both... Were both their shots? Well, that was interesting.
Oh, man. So that was... there was a moment there where an M40, M43... shot
could have ended the game.
Yeah, not changed it.
Really took out Dodo.
Dodo and Germ were close enough to where if it hit.
Oh no way!
The odds were low, but if it body contacted, actually no, I think it would be a splash in between the two with a good roll on Germ. I don't know, 657, probably not. I'd probably have to contact Germ and splash Dodo for 310. A lot less likely than I was looking.
Can you imagine
at.
If a oh that would been
it happens.
whoa Germ whoa.
That's a turret.
Whoa.
You can drive on it.
Germ, you okay? Dota now being sent to go find...
Wait. Is that an insulting move over his teammate?
No.
Now driving over a coolest turret?
How dare you? These tankers wouldn't do that.
How dare you?
These tankers wouldn't do that.
Yeah, they're nothing but love for each other, I promise.
I've seen them. Yeah, they love each other. So, Executus, right now, this is what I'm calling, right? He needs to just blind fire one of these tanks. And it's gonna be Germ.
Yeah.
Watch this.
One of the largest maps in the game. Just send it. You got it?
Just send it. He knows. I mean, I have confidence. It's just going to be amazing. He's going to, what he's going to do, blind fire one, and then it's going to be Germ. Germ's going to go down. And then Dodo is going to go run, try to find him. Going to get TD'd. Minute 30 seconds. It's going to be sweet. Any second now. Watch this blind fire. Watch it.
On the move, too, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, granted, if you're going to blind fire, what's the point naming?
On the move, man.
Yeah, blind fire with no intel at all, that is, you know.
On just the move.
Might as well send it.
Blind fire artillery. What is he going to do? He's going to bounce it off a palm tree. It's going to, like, whiplash it.
I don't think that's how that works.
Am I thinking of a different thing?
I'm not necessarily an artillery expert, but I don't think it how it works. And Dodoma getting a spot on Executus. Executus getting a spot on Dodoma.
Here it comes.
Executus driving a little bit further to get to safety.
No.
Oh, wow. Wait.
Oh, wow.
Did he get shot from two angles at the same time?
Germ still had a shot. That was a one shot coming out from Dodo. Congratulations to Noble for picking up their fifth victory, an amazing comeback here on our third match, and securing their number one spot for the finals.
Let's go into the stats.
Let's do it.
Coffee Thief with almost 4,000 in his bad shot. Pub Whisper, 3,232, 1,800 out of Flak, 1,400 out of Commander J. Everybody else below 1,000 for Noble, 2,900 out of Dodoma, 2,400 out of Militant, 1,900 out of X-Soldier, 1,700 out of Canadian Impact. I think that's 1,400 out of Akula, 1,000 out of Germ, and almost 900 out of Marsh.
All right, though. Again, congratulations to Noble once again. For picking up that fifth victory. Again, our third.
And first seed.
So a fantastic run for them for the season. Can't wait to see you guys in the finals in Vegas. And now up next, ladies and gentlemen, our fourth and final match. It's between Sip and Googly Bobbers. Don't go anywhere.
Hey, guys.